There are 1.2 million objects here at UCL Museums and Collections. Everything from fine art through to geology, Egyptian archaeology, right the way through to zoology. My name's Dean Veall, and I'm not in a museum today, I'm in a chemistry lab. Not the sort of place you might find museum objects, but today I'm meeting a researcher who's been at UCL for a staggering 70 years, Alwyn Davies. He's brought some objects from the chemistry collection, and he's got possibly one of the world's first X-ray photographs.
Alwyn, can you tell us a little bit more about yourself?
Yes, I came here as a student at the end of the war in 1944. Did a PhD, BSc and PhD, and then I was away for 4 years at BASc Polytechnic. Then I got invited back as a lecturer, reader, professor, head of department. I retired in 1991. Long time. Still going on.
And today we've got objects from the chemistry collection here at UCL. And they're all associated with one man. Who was that one man?
The one man is Norman Collie.
From what I can gather, he was a bit of a Victorian polymath. Can you tell us a little bit more about his interests?
Yes, he was accused of doing chemistry only in his spare time. He's popularly known as a pioneering mountaineer, a pioneer in photography. He was a connoisseur of Chinese porcelain, of wine, of racehorses. Many people think that he was a model for Sherlock Holmes. He did his PhD in Würzburg in South Germany, and he was back there visiting in 1895, when Röntgen found that his x-rays showed the bones in his wife's hand. This got Collie into photographing, not by visible light, but by x-ray irradiation. Collie comes back to college in January, and straight away he makes his own x-ray tube out of glass, his very glass blower, and x-rays everything he can lay his hands on. And we have some of his original x-rays here. This one is a lizard, aren't they nice? This one's a snake. And we have them also of a hand, of a fetus, of a fish and so on.
So within months of the discovery of the x-rays, he
it's
was...
It's within
his...
2 or 3 weeks. In February, and we don't know the exact date, doctors from UCH brought across to him an actress who said she'd got a broken needle in her thumb, and Collie, of course, x-rayed this for them. And we have here the images of that. Cool. Two views of the thumb. On the back, it says, taken by Collie, in Collie's own writing, February 1896. It's amongst the first. But one couldn't say it was the first.
So how do you think this photograph of thumb affected the development of x-rays in the UK?
Well, UCH and other places immediately recognised the potential of this, and so they started using x-rays routinely on patients. And in 1901, UCH decided to set up a department of photography and radiography. In 1902, they took 246 photographs for medical purposes by x-ray, and more in the following year. But this was happening all over the world, not just here. But the idea was so obviously good that everyone was using it. Maybe overusing it. They were damaging people by x-rays, but doing it too much. They apparently surrounded the point they wanted to x-ray with thin lead sheeting, but that's all.
Was that before people understood the dangers of x-rays?
That's right, yeah, sure, yeah.
And Collie wasn't affected by these x-rays?
No, he lived through, I think, 70-something. He died by falling into the lake when he was fishing and he caught pneumonia. So he lived a good old age.
The use of x-rays didn't affect him.
No.